Everyone, welcome back to our scenes. Today we are going to learn how to draw ray diagrams for concave mirror. Before moving forward, I would like to remind you to subscribe to my channel and do share my videos to your friends. Before moving forward, let me tell you that I have already done a video how to remember the position of the image with respect to the position of the object, as well as the varying sizes and the nature of the image. So you can go check it out. So now let's get started. First, I'm going to show you how to draw the basic skeleton for concave mirror. So the skeleton is followed for all the six diagrams of the concave mirror. So what you need to do is you need to draw a 15 centimeter line. So I'm going to draw a 15 centimeter line over here, and on this 15 centimeter line I'm going to mark points at 3 centimeter, 6 centimeter and 9 centimeter. So at 3 centimeter, that's the first point, I'm going to mark it as C, center of curvature, second point as F, principal focus, and the last point as P, pole of the mirror. And then I'm going to take my compass, keep the needle at C and my pencil point at P and draw the curvature. So this is the basic thing what we need to do for all the concave mirror ray diagrams. Now I have drawn here for all the six, the basic skeleton I have drawn, as you can see over here. Let's get started. So before moving forward, let me tell you that you need to draw a little shading over here towards the right side for both concave as well as convex mirror ray diagrams. This is to show that this particular part is behind the mirror. Okay, so let's start. Before that, let me highlight one more thing. So among the six diagrams, the first one, the third one and the sixth one have got slight differences. Other than that, the second, the fourth and the fifth one have got a similar pattern. So I'm going to do the second, the fourth as well as the fifth one first, so that you can get a hold of it. Then we'll go for the first one, the third and the sixth one. So for the second one, when my object is beyond C, that means a point beyond C, at a point beyond C, what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw my object. How am I going to draw? So in all the cases, I'm going to keep my object of the same size, whatever ray diagrams I'm drawing. So there won't be any differences. So I have kept my ray object as 1.5 centimeter long. So I'm going to mark it as AB. So now the point here, as I said, the second one, the fourth and the fifth one are the same. So here what you're going to see is from the object, two incident rays arises. One runs parallel, other one passes through center of curvature. So I'm going to show you how. So the first one, which runs parallel to principal axis, go straight, touches the mirror. I'm going to show the direction with an arrow mark. Then after being reflected, I know that this parallel ray has to go through principal focus. So I'm going to mark it as here with arrow mark. Now, as I said, the second ray diagram, the second incident ray, which is coming from the object, will always pass through center of curvature. One good thing about center of curvature is also that the incident ray and the reflected ray is the same. So I'm going to show both the arrows over here. So as you can see, I've got an intersection point over here. So here is exactly where my image will be drawn. This one will be A dash and this one will be the B dash. So as given, my image is supposed to be between C and F and it is going to be diminished. See here, the size is diminished. That was the second one. Now for the fourth one, when my object is between C and F, so I'm going to draw again 1.5 centimeter long object between C and F. Any point between C and F, I'm going to select. I'm going to draw my object, name it as AB, As said, one ray always travels parallel to principal axis for all the three diagrams. So I'm showing the arrow mark. So after reflection, I know that it is going to pass through principal focus. So you can say I am extending this, right? Okay. So now for the second ray, I have told you that one ray is running parallel, other one will always pass through center of curvature. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to connect this dot and this dot points together and then draw a line. So see here, this line is almost meeting here, so I'll just extend it a little more. Okay, so now for this particular one, I'm just going to extend a little, or you can just take a little longer line for the principal axis. Okay, so see here, this is the intersection point. I'm going to draw a line reaching the principal axis. So this point will be the A dash and this point will be the B dash. As said, my image is supposed to be beyond C and it is supposed to be enlarged. See here my object and see the size of the image. And then the fifth one, when my object is at F. So once again, the same thing, what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw 1.5 centimeter long object standing at F, A, B. As said, as I have informed before, one ray of light will run parallel to the principal axis and then pass through principal focus. The other ray of light will be passing through center of curvature. So as here, I'm connecting this dots. See, I'm going to show it like this. So as you can see, this looks parallel to one another, but they are not exactly parallel. They are going to meet at a infinity point, and they're going to be highly enlarged. So I'm just going to leave it over here by putting dots. Okay, so that was about the three which were similar, which had one ray incident that is parallel and the other incident ray passing through center of curvature. Now let's do further ones which are different than the others. Now for the first one, when the object is at infinity. So now in this case, what I'm going to do is towards my, see here, my principal axis, I'll just put a, one or two dots extending it. And then I'm just going to connect my 1.5 centimeter on the scale to this dot. See here, I hope you can see now. Okay. And then I'm going to start with zero and I'm going to extend the line till three. So this is going to be my object. So now, as always, we have seen a ray of light runs parallel. So here too, I'm going to keep a ray of light parallel to the principal axis coming from A, and it's going to pass through principal focus. Okay, now we have normally seen that the second ray of light passes through center of curvature, but this is not going to happen for infinity one. What we are going to do is we are going to extend from the B point, another ray of light will run parallel to the principal axis and then pass through F. So this goes something like this. So your image will be formed at F, point sized. Okay, so that is with the first one. Now the difference in the third one, what is the difference here? So now object is supposed to be at C, image is also supposed to be at C, and it's going to be of same size. See, what I'm going to do over here is I know my image or object is always 1.5 centimeter long, so I'm going to take that A, B, and right at this place at the bottom again I'm going to draw 1.5 centimeter and name it as A dash, B dash. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to connect. Can you see here? From the point A dash, I'm going to draw a parallel line running to the mirror. Okay, so arrow marks I'll tell you later. And same thing I'm going to do for the upper point, that is A, and then here. It looks like a, you know, rectangle with diagonals, just like that, with just the only difference will be that we are having here one side curvatured. Okay, so now one ray of light is running parallel to the principal axis and then passing, after the reflected ray will pass through principal focus. The other ray of light is incident on the principal focus, and after that it is going to run parallel to the principal axis. So this is the reflected ray meeting exactly at C. Now here, if we just draw the object and try to draw this and then, join the intersected point, normally students get the intersection point here. So which is absolutely wrong. So that is the reason why this is a trick to do for the, concave mirror ray diagram when the object is at C. Now, as for the last one. Okay, so when the object is between P and F. Okay, so once again, the same thing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a 1.5 centimeter long object. I'm going to name it as AB. Okay, so now every time we have taken one line parallel, right? But if we take this line parallel, see here, it cannot pass through F because it will go like this and then it is not able to pass. This object will act as a hindrance. So this is not possible. Instead, what we are going to do is we are going to draw an incident ray towards P. And then after reflection, it is again going to move in the, sorry. So it's just going to run in this direction. Now, the second ray of light, what I'm going to do is I'm going to connect the center of curvature with A and I'm going to draw a line. Okay, so as you can see, this ray of light and this ray of light, they are moving in different directions and there is no chance that they are going to meet. So what we are going to do is we are going to trace these lines back. I'm going to trace it as far as possible so that I get a common point from where they come from. See, for this particular diagram, you need, slightly, larger page, I could say. So you can have a trick over here. See, normally what we did in the first case for C, I have taken here from 3 centimeter, right? Instead, you can do it only after 0.5 centimeter over here. This should be 3 itself, no difference here, but only in the starting one, you can reduce it. So I have got a intersection point over here. So I'm going to draw a line to the principal axis. So I'm going to name it as A dash and B dash. So as said, my image is going to be behind the mirror. So it is behind the mirror and it's going to be enlarged. Yes, it is enlarged. See my object and see my image. And it is vertically, virtual and erect. So that's it. I hope you understood how to draw this concave ray diagrams. In my next video, I'll be uploading a video for drawing ray diagrams for convex mirror. So if you find my video helpful, do share it with your fellow mates and get them to subscribe to my channel as well. Thank you.